As we honor veterans today, American troops face new challenges ahead with the increase in deployment to Iraq. While President Barack Obama says U.S. troops will only train Iraqi and Kurdish forces to fight against ISIS, some Filipino-American soldiers say that boots on the ground are necessary to combat the Islamic militants. Rommel Conclara reports.
As President Obama authorized the deployment of an additional 1,500 U.S. troops to Iraq to train Iraqi and Kurdish forces to fight ISIS, troops back here in the States are gearing up. Among them is Filipino-American Army Sergeant Noel Valero, who says he's ready to go back to the Middle East to once again fight terrorism.
I'm definitely ready to deploy if need be, and I'm ready to do my job if they need me out there.
The president said that these U.S. soldiers will not engage in combat operations. The military advisors plan to be deployed to Al Anbar province, where ISIS controls much of the area. Valero says that airstrikes are not enough and that U.S. troops on the ground will be necessary to defeat ISIS.
The more boots on the ground we have, the more information we can get. And the more information we can get, it's going to be beneficial for a next plan of action to complete the mission.
Despite the reports of ISIS continuing to slaughter people in their path, the U.S. stated that airstrikes have been successful in gradually destroying ISIS.
There were coalition aircraft conducted a series of airstrikes November 7th in Iraq, destroying a vehicle convoy consisting of 10 ISIL-armed trucks. It clearly demonstrates that we're continuing to keep the pressure on. We're continuing to target and go after the ISIL terrorist network.
Along with the troop surge, the White House said in a statement that it will ask Congress for an additional $5.6 billion to fund the ongoing fight against ISIS. The budget request will be one of the first tests for Obama and the majority of Republican congressional leaders following the outcome of the midterm elections. Valero knows that the defeat of ISIS may take time, but he says that the Obama administration is using the right strategy against the terror organization.
I'm 100% confident in the U.S. and its allies' plan to defeat ISIS, and I feel that we will complete the mission, even though it's going to be for a long run.
U.S. officials are awaiting confirmation of the death or injury of ISIS leader Abu Bakr al-Baghdadi in coalition airstrikes over the weekend. Rommel Conclara, ABS-CBN News, San Bruno, California.